Alright, we have returned with Diggity Do Ropapa. And it's all three of us back again.
Shut up!
So this is going to be the same thing every time, right? You're just going to legitimately mispronounce the name.
I said it right.
No, you didn't. It's Danganronpa.
Exactly what I said.
No, it's not.
Anywho, if I may return to the game.
Okay.
So yeah, things got a little crazy last time. The body count has risen significantly.
Yeah, I lost three characters.
So to that end, we've done a bit of a shuffle. Lauren will now be doing Kyoko
and Toka. And I will be doing Taka now.
Yeah, and I'm probably going to drop the funny accents and stuff.
You're probably just going to talk normally?
A, it was getting confusing in my tiny brain. And B, yeah, I mean, we're moving into a bit more serious phase of the game here, so.
Yeah, I think it's time that we should, like.
Jack, can you get closer to that microphone?
Huh?
What's it taste like?
You're blocking the microphone for the rest of us, bud.
Sorry.
Come on now, bud.
I also got a cat in my way, so I hope people can hear me.
Yeah, that's. Hopefully. Anywho, without too much more ado, let's load this up and see what fresh hell we're gonna get into now.
It's just gonna get worse, I'm telling you.
Oh, yes.
Chapter 2 is called School Life Nighttime.
You will begin from where you last left off. Is this okay? Do I have an option?
Dot dot dot.
Oh, it's nighttime.
Like
that. Are we actually in our room again?
This looks like Sayaka's room.
Hold on.
Or no, wait.
Pillow is pink.
Right. No,
the
I think.
Trash can is pink.
It's
check the.
No. You can remember Makoto's room is all messed up. You're all good and audible.
Oh, good.
Awesome.
Just a future in our way was hard to tell.
Nope. Took the trash can again. Well, maybe I should click on some stuff to see if I can get some more coins. Yeah!
I might happen to see how many coins do we have now.
I think it's 92.
Yeah, something like that.
92?
We gained a bunch.
Oh, right, okay.
Gained 75 bear coins. I think it's
going
to do the same thing.
Well, he is for everything, yeah. I just wanted to see if there's any more coins. I think it wants us to go to bed.
Yeah, probably. It says nighttime, so.
Who are you?
Can you
try to get me?
Oh, it is his room.
It's gone.
How is everything cleaned up so fast?
Wow.
She really is.
Scratches on the walls or on the floor?
No. She's saying she's gone as in, like, can't believe she's dead.
No, I think he's saying she's gone as in there's no dead chick in my bathroom.
There's no dead lady.
And it's not covered in blood anymore.
No dead lady.
No dead lady in my bathroom.
It's almost like there's men raising there to begin. Oh! Every last time Sayaka's in existence has disappeared without a
trace. I don't know about you, but I wouldn't want to sleep in that room. I don't care whether everything is gone.
Had a class try before we took the elevator back up. Monokuma told us.
Oh, I almost forgot.
Since the class trial is over, I'll go ahead and dispose of all the corpses.
What are you gonna do?
It's okay. No need to thank me. The shady, delighted, smiling faces is thank enough for me.
Yeah, she gone. So Lucas.
After all, nobody wants to look at a rotting corpse, right? That can't be good for your health.
Violate school regulations.
Yeah, I'd probably just drop. Didn't even have time to mourn Sayaka and Yoko's death. You did the same thing you did. Sure, that's exactly why you did it. A bad joke, sickening dream, but I have to accept the reality of it all. I headed back to the dining hall to meet up with the others. Sorry I'm late.
No,
Hey, are you okay, Makoto?
Listen to me!
You sure took your sweet time. I'm just about to go get you and drag you back here. Sorry. So, what happened? Was your room fixed up like you said? I imagine it'd be pretty hard to save the rotted corpse in your bathroom.
Oh, that's sensitive.
Yeah.
Hey, come on.
Jesus, that's fucked up, man. Why would you say something like that?
My room was spotless. There wasn't anything left.
Yeah, when the biker dude's like, dude.
Like, the whole thing never happened.
I see. It must be tough staying there, knowing what happened. Why don't you just stay in Sayaka's room?
Well, staying there with a scent is still... With a scent still hanging in the air, that would hurt just as much. Plus, I decided that I can't turn away from his death.
To be fair, when you die, you lose your bowels, so her scent's probably hanging in the air, too.
Makoto? Hey, cheer up. Getting depressed isn't gonna help anything, right? If we all work together, I'm sure we can find a way out of here.
You got it!
So everyone just try and cheer up and get back on track.
It seems to me the way out's been
Is
pretty
good. Is that honestly supposed to make us feel better?
Huh?
We were already working together, and yet someone was still murdered. Anyone could betray us at this point. Now that it's happened once, it's a question of when, not if, the next one takes place.
Yeah, because Sayaka made the first move.
...
But if we work together against the mastermind, nobody will have any reason to do something like that.
Does she use turtle wax on her chestages? They are awfully shiny. Keep telling yourself that it'll be over, or I'll be over here in the real world.
Oh, fire me.
Working together, fighting a common enemy, like it or not, it's not that simple.
What do you mean?
The mastermind seems to be much more powerful than we ever suspected. They took over Hope Peak, which was supposed to be well defended, then modified it to fit their desire.
Yeah, seriously, everyone will betray, could betray.
They created Monokuma, which seems to be incredibly advanced, and they're providing for our every need. And the cherry on top is the execution list.
Oh.
Everything has been planned down to the last excruciating detail. This is not the work of your everyday cycle. Defying them may be too great of a risk.
So,
then what are we supposed to do?
Anyone who truly does want to escape will just have to follow the rules. In which case, the only option is to deceive those around you and win the game.
No. No.
What?
No what?
I don't want to live if it means killing someone else to do it. I don't want to kill anyone else.
Anyone else? What do you mean?
Died because we all voted for him, right? It's no different than from us killing him ourselves.
But
if we hadn't voted for him, then we all would have died instead, right? That isn't what you wanted, is it?
She's right. If you heap that kind of blame on yourself, you'll turn into a full-fledged masochist. Chihiro, listen. You're not to blame. Not you, not Leon, and not Sayaka. The mastermind is responsible for everything that's happened. We had no choice but to vote. I can't even imagine what would have happened to us if we'd refused. In the end, it was Monokuma who ultimately killed Leon. So don't waste your anger on yourself. Instead, direct it at the mastermind. All of you.
Did somebody say bung?
That's no
problem.
Yeah.
Shit, sorry.
Fine, we can check the transcript.
Yeah.
We can check the transcript, so we're not screwed.
The burden of judging others is a heavy one to bear. So be well aware of your actions.
not the time for puns right now.
Order and stability rely on the sacrifice and responsibility of everyone. Okay then. Sweet dreams, everyone.
Gotten sick of it.
What was that about just now?
Was he saying it's our fault what happened? That's pretty cruel, man. That piece of shit. Who does he think he is?
... And so the day drew to a close. A tense, maddening day that saw the death of three classmates, Sayaka, Yonko, and Leon. But this is just the beginning.
That was one day?
Our despair had only just begun.
Oh, the clues, like gathering the clues and doing the trial.
Oh, yeah,
we've
been here for about 4 or 5 days.
Yeah.
Chapter 2, Boy's Life of Despair.
Oh.
Oh, dear.
Concentrating on the boys.
Moment. I woke up the next day to Monokuma's normal morning announcement, then he called us all to the gym. What's he gonna do to us this time? We were practically frozen with fear, but Monokuma was determined to get us involved in his little game. And with that goal in mind, he began it.
Okay, lift your arms up and down.
Is the only one doing it?
Who is?
Taka.
Ew, he's kind of...
He's like...
Now reach way up and bend way down.
Those muscles,
and
you're ready for some
murdering.
That's creepy.
Uh-huh. I'm the field of Ryan. Being sick and sad, I didn't be out of here to stay healthy.
You're the one keeping us stuck inside.
Don't sweat the small stuff. That's my motto.
Yeah.
Whoa, I sounded pretty cool just now, don't you think?
No.
Did you fall in love with me? Am I just to die for? Am I just to die in writhing agony for?
No.
So why did you call us here? Certainly it wasn't just to make us exercise.
Just to make you exercise? Just to make you exercise? Hey, exercise makes you laugh. Exercise will make you cry. Now if you keep doing these exercises, you won't come to the sacred of the assassin. Pass down from generation to generation, the empire of darkness. The power can be yours. That sounds like the kind of junk a middle schooler would come up with. It doesn't matter. Just
what?
Get to the.
Oh yeah.
It doesn't matter. Just get to the point. Did you really call us down here just to exercise?
Wait.
Sorry. I was trying to chew a cord. Stop it.
Of course not. You think I have that kind of free time on my hands?
Yeah.
Okay, so then...
Like the main announcement!
Every time you overcome a class trial here at Oak Peak, a whole new world will open up to you.
A whole new world?
You guys?
It'd really suck if you had to live here forever with nothing new to stimulate you! Besides, I know how you kids got these days with your ADD and ADHD. I gotta keep you motivated. Oh, hold on. Minimum is the most evil. Evil person in the game. Monokuma. Oops.
Minimums? I'm gonna call him that now.
So go ahead. Look around all you want. Enjoy the brand new post-trial world until you explode. Five minimums. With that, Monokuma disappeared, leaving us even more confused than he showed up.
I'd be confused about the open doors that were locked before.
But, new world?
Is he talking about a way to get outside?
Unlikely.
That seems unlikely.
Yeah. I bet he'd be doing that.
Well, we don't know till we look.
Whatever he meant, it seems we'll have to search the school one more time.
Okay then, let's split up and start investigating. When you're done, everyone meet back up at the dining hall and share what we found.
You're basically a one-trick pony, you know that.
More like a staple food source. Now let's get going. Now let's get moving. Words are hard. Seeing his words as your signal, everyone scattered and left the gym. The sound effect and minimums disappears every time and makes me laugh, no matter what.
The cartoon sound?
Wow!
Wow!
Anything we can see in here? But it's a monitor, but it's probably going to say the same thing. The monitor is going to be on. If I break it, monitor will might come and punish me. Oh, what is that?
That's just a camera.
Oh, that was something new for once.
Alright, so just press B to exit.
Oh, God. Okay.
Where shall we go?
Oh,
here. Hey, Makoto, did you see what's inside the display case? Bad. This is super bad, man.
What are you talking about? I didn't notice anything all that weird in there.
Sure, to the untrained eye, it's nothing. But this is awful. A bad, awful, terrible trap. That stuff you see lined up there, any good could come by,
god.
Or any god could come by and use it to send a message.
Huh?
I've been struck with knowledge, I can't read today. It's an ill omen of total devastation and ruin. Let me out of here. Let me out.
I have no idea what he's talking about, so maybe I'll just leave him alone.
Maybe I don't see anything different.
Inside the display case are trophies and other items. Winning championships and stuff probably came naturally to anyone going through here.
I don't see anything different in the box.
Mm-hmm. Oh wait, maybe it's... to the left or right?
I couldn't go any further left.
Makoto, look! The gate block and the stairs are gone. I'm missing a path to the second floor and opened up.
Oh, sweet.
You also have opened the door to double check the areas we already know about, just in case. Aren't I so clever to think of that? I really impress myself sometimes.
Really? You do.
Well, I'll leave the school to you. I thought he meant like, well, I'll leave the school over to you. I thought he was like, wow.
Well, I mean,
so
you might as well double check.
But
it's stuff, right?
That's still blocked off.
Oh, I saw
this is just a bathroom,
there.
Right?
Yeah, we couldn't do anything in there.
I should look around school first. We need to find out what Monokuma meant by new world.
What if you have to use the bathroom?
What is this?
The nurse's office. The nurse's office.
There's not really much use for a nurse's office
in
school.
Oh, Mondo.
He's like, what's Mondo looks?
Danny kind of weird?
You just saw him peeking out from around the corner.
What are you doing?
I went and checked the metal hatch in the main hall just to be sure, but just like I figured, it hasn't moved an inch. Shit.
Yeah, I'd be surprised if he made things that easy for us.
Hey! What? Don't make that face. You look like a metal thing that worked. You want me to put some fighting spirit in you? Well, do you?
No thanks. I think I've got enough for now.
Well, okay, I'm gonna go look for another way out then.
God.
What?
Oh, just on the back of his jacket said crazy. Is it sad that the first thing that came to my head was a Patsy Cline song?
Yes.
A mental hatch.
It's his theme song in my head now.
Mental hatch.
Where's the store?
Oh, right over there. Right. So.
Wait. Where the end sign is?
Turn around. Right there.
I didn't have the door. I shouldn't look around the store.
No. But that's the store.
Okay. I think he just wants us to go upstairs, really.
Yeah.
Whoa, wasn't Mondo over there before?
Yep.
Why are you over here now?
Oh, no, he was there. He came around the other way.
Oh.
He took the metal hatch and the main hatch.
The mental hatch.
Yes. Check the mental hatch.
Who chose the lighting for this place?
Monokuma. Can't you tell?
I like how
dark.
Where's the stairs?
Well, there were stairs by,
Over by, Taka. Hachi's leaning around line.
stairs right there.
Could have launched into Taka's jump.
The gate of the block of stairs have been open. This is what Monica was meant by a new world. And so, what's up there?
I don't know. We'll find out. Ooh, it's blue.
The second floor of the school.
More bathrooms I can see.
Maybe there's some kind of clue here. Minimum picks all. Yeah, I'm sure, but we've got any problem here.
Always check the bathroom.
Never know, there could be something very special on it.
A lot of fishies in this one.
Wait, what's over there?
In the bathrooms by the dormitories.
Ooh.
In the boys' bathroom, there's a big fish tank.
This is where the bathroom cleans the fryers for. I don't see anything useful in here.
Yeah, you're not thinking like a murderer, son.
Well, maybe check inside the stalls.
Hey, I'm getting out of here alive. I don't know about y'all.
Ooh, that must be a classroom.
Yep.
Let's see what's in here. Wait, is this a classroom that we started?
Oh, butterflies. The baby is sleeping. Please be quiet.
Let's see.
This must be what he meant by a new world.
I don't like where that sounds.
I should probably take a really close look around.
I really don't like what it means by baby is sleeping.
It's a picture of Monokuma.
Oh,
of course they are.
Oh, the baby dead? I know he's playing with the kids, but it's hot. Ooh, the tower belongs without any way of knowing. I really don't like her.
Why is it like a strict get in bed at this time or you're dead?
Well, it's not get in bed, it's just nighttime starts at 10. There are areas that are off limits at night.
If you get caught in and you explode?
Most of the school is still open to you. You can stay out of bed if you want. You just can't fall asleep anywhere but in the dormitory.
Yeah,
and you pass out at a certain time.
Why is the dining hall off limits?
A library?
Fine, nerd.
It's a big room. You don't know what you're gonna find there.
Yeah, I passed it. I was just checking all the.
Oh, okay.
Bet you that mousy girl's in here.
What? Oh, there's a bunch of people in here.
It's a regular party.
Oh, shelf is packed tight with books. I'm looking at it. All things incredibly messy. This library's been neglected for a pretty long time. As nice the school itself is, whoever's in charge of upkeep has been pretty lazy. Strange.
I'm just looking at you, crazy lady.
You must be pretty happy.
That's me.
You must be pretty happy to have all these books around, huh, Tokyo?
Not particularly. Nothing's really caught my attention so far.
Nerd. Oh, gee, there's a plethora of books. It's true, but the content seems lacking. Where are the comic books? Where is the young adult section?
Comic books? Young adult? That stuff's a waste of time.
Hey, shut up. Percy Jackson's a great series.
Jackson is a great series.
I see what you write, Miss Fuaka. Talented as you... Fukawa. Talented as you are, your stuff isn't any more worthwhile.
Stories are filled with true love and pure feelings, sir. Don't compare them to that garbage of yours.
I'm
like
Nicholas Sparks!
Hey, Brady doesn't mean anything. It's just a bunch of jumbled up letters.
Isn't that what all writing is?
Someone should just burn it all.
Hey, Percy Jackson's a great series. Ooh, the lady don't protest too much. Me thinks.
Shakespeare.
I bet you're secretly into boy-on-boy action.
What a perv this child
God
is.
God dang.
Boy-on-boy? I don't care if it's an anime or comics or fanfic or whatever. It's all film. Throwaway culture that will be trashed and forgotten in half a decade.
You're the medic and you're a nerd.
Just talking about it makes me sick to my stomach. I feel like I'm gonna throw up.
Uh-huh, sure.
Yeah. Because, you know, things like Dracula were gone within 5 years of being written.
Yes.
You insulted me, and you insulted my honor.
Star Wars, wasn't that that program created by Ronald Reagan?
This door really kind of freaked me out. I've never seen anything like it.
Is there really a program by Reagan called Star Wars?
Yes.
Oh my god.
He wanted to put lasers on airplanes. It's pretty cool, actually.
Toko really...
I mean, in a general sense of, hey, that's pretty cool.
Isn't that weird? Or do you feel like Toko doesn't want to see a plane?
But still, this library is most interesting.
Huh? What's interesting about it?
Oh, nothing. I was just thinking out loud.
I'm absolutely shocked.
How come?
There's all these books here, and not one copy of any of my works.
But probably because it's trash.
Well, yeah. Why would they have comics in the library? Plus, most fanfic is just porn drawn by a bunch of amateurs.
Oh, wow.
Well,
wow.
That's
a generalization.
You just don't get it. Not at all.
That's a slash fic, okay?
There is a difference.
I do get it. And with a face like yours, anyone can tell me, can tell nothing you do is worthwhile.
Ooh!
Damn, man.
Jesus.
Say whatever you want about me, but never judge a book by its author.
No, I mean, I'm kind of with the weirdo.
Nothing at all. What you see before you is nothing more than the rim that grind that contains the meaty pulp of my genius.
I mean, it's an okay sentiment said in the weirdest possible way.
Yeah, I mean...
my creation is what determines my meaning and value.
Yeah, that's
too
much.
So full of it.
Trans fats, that is.
Trans fats?
I'm used to being misunderstood. You think weak attacks like yours will drop my HP? Those two really worry me.
They're totally gonna do it.
What's on that envelope?
Oh, Kyoko! The shelf is covered in dust, but on the shelf is a letter. What's this?
What's this?
Oh, Peak Academy?
It was buried under a thick layer of dust. It must have been sitting there for quite a while. Well? Shall we see what's inside?
But you shouldn't read other people's mail without the permission.
Oh, for God's sake, Makoto.
God dang.
What we shouldn't do is leave this here without finding out what's inside.
Thank you, Kyoko. Okay. I broke the seal on the dusty envelope and pulled up the single sheet of paper I found inside. I unfolded the paper and read what was written there. From the Hope Peak Academy Executive Office. Throughout the years, we have been committed to shaping the youth who will one day shape the world. We have a long, proud history as an institution of higher learning with full governmental support. Our graduates enter society ready to take on active leadership roles in every major job field. However, Hope Peak Academy must now lower the curtain on its glorious history for the time being. This decision was not an easy one to make, but serious issues beyond our control have made it necessary. But make no mistake, this is not the end for Hope's Academy. We intend to reopen our doors as soon as the issues forcing our closure have been resolved. That being said, this is the end for now. And I would like to personally and sincerely thank everyone for your help and support over the years. For now, we are awaiting official governmental authorization to formally cease operations. What does this mean?
The contents of this letter are quite interesting indeed.
It would seem Hope's Peak has stopped functioning as a school. And judging by the amount of dust the letter had collected, it doesn't seem to have happened recently. If I had to guess, I'd say this letter could be at least a year old.
So, you're saying Hope Peak closed down at least a year ago?
Most likely, the mastermind took over the school in order to put on his little performance.
But that would mean it was closed when I got here just a few days ago. But I didn't get that sense at all. Plus, if the school had shut down, Don't you think it would have been in all the newspapers and stuff? I mean, pretend it could have happened over a year ago, right? But before I got here, I looked stuff up online about the school and never saw anything about this.
That must have all been part of the mastermind's plan. They lured us all in here. Someone who could create a place to judge and execute people could potentially be capable of anything.
Yeah, pretty much.
Of course, that's all assuming that this letter is real.
However, if it is real, though, that does solve one mystery surrounding the school. The reason there are no other students here could be because the school had already closed down.
This game goes in stages.
That would be a nice, simple solution, it's true.
Look, this game goes in stages. Scary, not scary, not scary, terrifying, sad, not. Yeah. But then, what about the other part? This decision was not an easy one to make, but serious issues beyond our control have made it necessary. But make no mistake, this is not the end for Hope Creek Academy. We intend to reopen our doors as soon as the issues forcing our closure have been resolved. What do they mean by serious issues? That's apparently why the school had to close. Is there any connection between that and what's happening to us now?
If the two events are in fact connected, uncovering that connection would be a useful clue, on top of figuring out the mastermind's motive. Although, I can't really say anymore until we find more details.
So in other words, only the mastermind knows the truth right now.
Yeah, the mastermind's motive. If we can figure out why they would want to imprison us over here, will that be enough to get us out of here? Just call him Monokuma. Or... instead of calling them the mastermind, just call him Monokuma.
Well, Monokuma is
the mastermind or a different...
He's a construct. He's built by somebody, right?
He's built by somebody in order to essentially act as their will.
It's remarkably dusty in here, and the lighting is less than ideal. For a library, it's not the kind of place I'd want to do much reading in.
Now, those buildings lots of stuff to look at.
Yeah. There's a thick layer of dust on top of the desk. It looks like this library has been neglected for a pretty long time. As nice as the school itself is, whoever's in charge of upkeep has been pretty lazy. Strange.
Oh, yeah, we did.
Yeah,
oh, but I got a bear token.
Nice.
Oh,
monitor.
Sometimes they just give you things?
Yeah.
Yeah, you get coins. Well, there's something on the desk right in front of Kyoko there.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that thing. That weird looking thing. It looks like a laptop. The laptop looks pretty old and old covered in dust.
Oh, it does look pretty old.
Mm. Wow.
Oh wow, that's an old laptop. Probably comes with a
pad. It's broken. I tried pressing the power button earlier, and nothing happened.
It's broken, huh? Too bad. I was gonna play Minecraft on it.
I'm pretty sure Minecraft would probably destroy that laptop.
I was making a joke, dude. I was hoping I could use it to go online and see what's going on in the outside world. It was broken. There's nothing I can really do about it.
Did you check the monitor? If you're looking for coins, I'll very much
so. I'm sorry for some making the gifts. I want to build you. There's a TV that works. Let's see if this camera doesn't work. How long am I going to be stuck here being left over the cameras? Oh.
So is there anything else?
Oh, so what about that clock? Oh, you can't check it. Okay.
Well, there's a door right behind.
Yeah. There's another room over there.
What's behind this door?
It's some kind of archive. All I saw in there was stacks of old books and files.
Well, I'd like to take a look.
I can't imagine what business you would have in there.
Why do you not
want
me to go in there?
I don't really have any reason to check it out.
Go in there.
But why do you not want me to go in there? Huh?
But you hiding by Yakamaku? I don't know what it is.
Bayakua, I think? Bayakua?
Fill me up before I offend Japanese people.
Okay. I think
there's another
classroom
over there.
This one? But this is the one I went to, right?
That's the one you went to. All the way at the opposite end.
Wait, I can press B to run.
Yeah.
Oh, when do you know about that?
You're done.
Well, you never figured that
either.
I knew about it. It was forever.
Oh. reality isn't everything.
That looks like a bigger, angrier Monica.
Yeah, that looks like grizzly bear versus
No.
Maybe I'm not allowed to break
the
block
because
I can't see anything. Nope, I'm not breaking the control. Yes! Yes, he sometimes would give me stuff. I know it's pointless, but I can't tell if it's a claw, blah, 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 so bad, but I guess it's a little bit of a feeling. Oh, hey!
What's up?
Hello.
Hello. You get underscore O?
Oh.
This is one of the
welcome.
This is one of the monitors Monokuma appears on. I'd love to smash stupid things, but who knows what would happen to me if I did.
Oh, I do.
Yeah.
You'd be killed.
Yeah, think. Yeah, you'd be
think
dead.
At this point, Monokuma's made that very clear.
Yeah.
That if you break anything there, you're gonna die.
So the, off the hallway coming up here, can you go up the stairs further to the third floor? Yeah.
No.
Okay.
Yeah.
But
that
is
probably
this,
unlocks after the...
Is this the pool over here?
Yeah, that's what I was gonna ask you next.
Cool, let's see if we can go in here.
Oh, yes, we can.
Oh, it's here.
Treat.
What? Oh,
it, okay, whoa. That is not a common pool accessory. There is a minigun on the roof.
Yep.
Fully loaded chain gun.
Yep.
Why? But that's a stupid question.
Anyway.
Oh, Makoto. Hey, guess what?
There's a freaking gun on the roof.
Guess what I found? A pool.
There's
a pool here.
Yeah.
Pool.
You think a pool is the most interesting feature of this room?
Yes, swimmer, so yes.
There's also a gun there. You don't have to keep repeating it. I got it.
And there's a ton of exercise equipment in the locker room. Sakura is going to go nuts when she finds out.
And there's a gun? Yeah, you're right about that. Can't seem way more excited than usual.
And?
Is anybody going to talk about the minigun?
Is that a real gun? Not like we're here. Why would we need something like that? In case you try to break the camera? You think? Hey, Chihiro, have you checked out the pool yet?
No.
What?
I don't like wearing swimsuits.
Yeah, you do sound like the type who might not be into that kind of thing.
It sounds like the locker rooms here have all the exercise equipment you could ask for.
What, James?
It seems kind of
maybe I'll give it a try. I kind of like to get a little stronger.
You want to get stronger? I have to say, that's kind of unexpected. Why the minimum is that excessive? Why is the fight so big? Minigun.
He meant to say minigun and he wrote minimum again.
But I want to be brave enough to step foot into the locker room.
Huh? You don't even want to go in the locker room?
It's not that I don't want to, it's just...
There's a freaking minigun above me.
I'm
kind of
scared.
Oh,
I don't get it. Is she afraid of locker rooms or something? No!
It's not like there's anything dangerous in this room.
That's a pretty weird phobia.
It's not really a weird phobia to not want to go into a changing room and change in front of a bunch of other people.
Also, there's a minigun!
God, it's like Monokuma all over again.
The second floor has opened up. The living area has grown and a number of facilities are now available.
Cool.
Whatever else is going on, I must admit, things have been made much more comfortable for us. If things continue like this, the occasional class trial may not be so bad. We're still bad. We're still super bad.
It means a murder, though.
What?
Is everyone in this game just psychotic?
Murder's funny.
It's funny to watch people suffer.
I swear, everyone in this game is just psychotic.
There are a bunch of... I didn't get to read that, but okay.
Yeah, it was
louder. Oh,
what
about that thing up there? Oh, hold back and hit the mic. Looks like one of those lifesaver flotation donuts. Oh, what?
Did you say lifesaver? Because I heard a lightsaber.
I said lifesaver. You would die!
The
surveillance camera. Even here we're being watched.
I don't.
In the pool?
No, this is just like into the ocean. Yeah. It's not even into the locker room yet.
Behind the door in the locker room?
Yeah. Oh, and I guess you need your handbook to get into the locker rooms.
Why would you want to?
Why?
Really?
Because it's going to keep track of people that go in there.
Really?
Monokuma.
They want to walk in the locker room. You have to flag your personal link handbook across the concrete when you come in there. However, due to maximum security within each locker room, only a boy's handbook can open the boy's locker room, and the same goes for the girls.
That's just common sense.
And that's the bottom line.
What if someone opens the door and then someone else sneaks in?
Anyone who commits such indecency will be punished without mercy for the scandal of sexual
depravity.
See? There's a Gatling gun mounted on the
That's what the Gatling gun's for.
It's
not a bad use.
Wait, just a second. I bet it really hurt. Get shot by that
thing. It would really hurt.
I
think
it
probably would.
Really hurt.
I think it would probably
yeah.
kill you.
Yeah, it would just really hurt.
I think it'd be a little worse than
yeah,
that.
Thank you.
The rounds that it fires are the size of my finger.
It'd probably kill you with the first shot.
But what happens if someone learns their handbook from someone else? A boy could borrow a girl's handbook, and that would get them into the girl's locker room, huh?
What? That never occurred to me! I think someone would need no love! What happened? It's so devilish! Okay, then how does this sound? Time for a new rule! At this moment, loaning your handbook to another student is strictly prohibited! So nobody can get their handbook to anyone else, right? You like that? I guess I'm a genius, right? It's got my brain in 100% cotton!
I'm
like Monokuma all over again.
I do not imagine anyone would have lent their handbook out in the first place.
Yeah.
After all, they would likely be held responsible for anything that person might do when using the handbook. But you know, you seem awfully concerned with all this locker room security stuff.
It's because all you teenagers are sex brain maniacs! At that age, you try
pumping a plastic bottle.
So to keep everything unseemly from happening, I have to maintain a rigorous watch!
I got that right? Then in that case, I would ask that you keep the same close eye on your dorms. If some man and some woman decide to share a room, there would be nothing to stop them.
All I care about is protecting the holy image of the school itself. I don't care what happens in your private dorm. By force or by cunning, do whatever you want.
I hate you so much.
Okay, the new regulations now in place. See ya.
Okay.
I bet he really hurt.
Man, that stupid bear totally ruined my mood. Maybe I'll just go take a dip to cheer myself up.
You got it.
Celeste, Shihiro, you want to come with me?
I'm sure you do.
There's nothing I hate more than getting water on my face.
Very
sorry.
Specific
I'll
hate.
Pass this time.
Well, can you imagine the hell it must go through to get her hair like that?
Weird, the twirlies?
Yeah. How come? When you're in a funk, there's nothing better than a good spin to pull you out of it.
I'm pretty sure that only applies to you. Anyway, now I have a pretty good idea what's on the second floor. But I didn't see anything that might lead to any kind of exit or anything.
That was pretty clear from the beginning.
All I can do now is hope someone else found something worthwhile.
You only get out by murder. I thought that was pretty clear from the start.
Okay, I better head back to the dining hall as soon as possible.
I wanted to look at the pool.
Is everyone in this game stupid?
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, how'd it go? Did anyone discover any interesting new anything? What about news? The library!
Okay. And a pool. A freaking pool. And locker rooms filled with exercise equipment.
And a gun!
There was not, however, anything resembling an escape room.
Well, I don't know if you could blow a hole in the wall with that minigun.
Yeah, assuming you could get control of the minigun.
Well, hey, no reason to get all sulky. Wait till you hear about my amazing discovery. The warehouse and bathhouse on the first floor of the dorms are now open.
Oh, am I here making better?
And the war and the warehouse is chock full of food, clothes, whatever you want. There's so much, it's insane. So go ahead and stuff yourself to the gills whenever you feel like. Ha ha ha.
Keep in mind, of course, that going out at night pack is still prohibited. Please do not forget.
Okay, and what about a fucking way out of here? You find anything like that?
Oh, well, it's a bit of a no.
There wasn't anything in the warehouse we could use to get our asses out of here? Nothing?
Yeah, I find that hard to believe.
Yeah. Oh, unfortunately, no. Not that I saw.
Hey, come on.
You fucking people.
What?
Who gives a shit if we have a goddamn pool now, or a warehouse, or whatever the fuck? We're still trapped in this piece of shit school. We need to find a goddamn way out.
Jeez!
That's just excessive.
Well, now, there's no point in taking your anger out on us. Adaptation is the key, yes? For now, we must each find a way to enjoy our current situation.
Whatever you say, you fucking loon.
Jeez! For now, let's continue our investigation and let everyone know we should discover something.
Trying to place the accent, can't place the accent.
So, are we done for today?
Probably. Well, yeah, I guess so. He's all down now. The air seems to suddenly grow heavy again. This is a mastermind's plan to give us hope just to turn around and betray that hope? Yes?
Sounds pretty mastermind-y to me.
Yeah. Bing bong.
Bing bong.
Every night.
Somebody say bong?
Yes, blah, blah, blah.
It is open, so soon the door to the dining hall will be locked. And
yes.
Soon that's okay, then. Sweet,
sweet. Yeah. You wonder why we're not reading it. It's just been the same thing.
Yeah, it's been the same thing, like, every night.
We all probably have to leave our room during nighttime. There's not much else to do. Guess I'll just go to bed. God, I really...
Oh, here we go.
Oh, God.
Happening?
Mr. Mona, come on! You have a second! I don't really like myself! I don't have any kind of skill or hobby I can say I'm good at! And my grades are totally average, too! My reflexes are okay, but I'm great, not awful! If I get to a decent college where I make a few friends, maybe even find a little girlfriend! Which is exactly why I don't like who I am! Taste. I have any imagination. I'm a perfectly average cardboard cutout.
Is he mocking Makoto?
I'm pretty sure.
You know what I mean?
Right,
Mr. Makoto? I think he's just mocking Makoto.
Yeah.
Ding dong.
Does it literally say ding
it
dong,
ding
bing
dong,
bong?
Bing bong, yeah.
Maybe not if you watch the full day in the darkness.
I wanted to let you know that your key handbooks have been updated. New regulations have been added, so please take a look and enjoy your school life more than ever before.
Oh, yeah, we should probably check those out.
Oh,
yeah, warning me.
Oh, must be referring to you. Right now, I need to hurry up and then head to breakfast.
I need to use the restroom.
I guess I can play.
Does time pass?
Did you want to just have Jack talk for a few minutes? And
yeah, it's like, oh, I kind of want to play, though.
Well, you might run into something new that nobody here has seen.
Alright.
When I come back, you can take the control if you want.
So I think I'm going to be talking for a few minutes, you know? Just gonna try to entertain the folks. So, Lucas, how are you enjoying the stream so far? I have a feeling someone is going to die soon. I don't want it, but I just have a weird feeling that someone's gonna die soon.
Knowing this game, you're probably right.
I hated the Sayaka's death. I really did like Sayaka. I didn't care very much for Yoko or Leon either, to be honest. That's why I didn't pay me much to do that. The pay me for Leon's death just as powerful as it was. And getting stoned to death with baseballs.
Yeah, that was definitely a ride. No one wanted to partake in.
It's good. This game sends shivers down my spine, but I love it. Me too.
That's
me
pretty
too.
Accurate.
Yeah, that's how I feel too. Sending shivers down my spine, but I'm so freaking obsessed with this game now. This is a problem. I play a game for the first time and then super into it afterwards. I just want to keep playing until I beat it. And then I'm going to play it again. And then again. And then again. Until I get tired of it. Which, music is good and the game is very cinematic in its own special way. It helps me for the rest of the episodes.
Yeah.
That's the joy of this game. Oh, the dining room.
I wonder if the deaths are a set order or if it's random. I don't know.
You can make friends and stuff with people here by giving them gifts and stuff, right?
So. Yeah, I wonder if the deaths depend on who you make friends with. Likely.
Hi, Mom. You say morning, Makoto.
Morning, Makoto.
Good morning. Is it morning here already?
Yo, yo.
Oh, that's some of Dad's.
Yeah. Right here.
Oh. Can I take the...
Yeah, go for it. Mostly just
the whoops!
Bottom.
Sorry.
Nope, still waiting on Taka or...
What the heck? No Taka, I imagine he's trying to get... Oh, it's on auto! That's why!
Press the right bumper.
Right bumper?
Yeah. Sometimes it's just stuck on auto. There you go.
God dang.
I'm sure he'll be here soon enough. Just be patient.
You can move over a bit.
I don't mind waiting for them, but there is one problem.
Which is?
I am thirsty.
Come on! Yeah.
How the hell is that a problem?
It'd be cool if it was random, because in that case the game is different every time you play, although it might follow the outline of the TV show.
Well, the TV show, I actually found out the anime came out because of the game.
It was made off of the game, yeah. And apparently there's like 40-something seasons.
Yeah. Ifumi, would you make me some tea?
Why would you trust him with it?
Milk tea, if you please.
Why me?
Your roundish figure reminds me of the owner of the coffee shop I used to frequent.
That's your reason.
That's the politest way of calling someone fat I've ever heard.
I can feel my throat drying out. Quickly, please.
Oh, she's trying to get rid of him.
Okay. Okay. Apparently unable to refuse the order, Ifumi skulks his way into the kitchen. A few minutes later... Oh! Thank you for waiting! Ifumi reappears with tray in hand, the gentle aroma growing stronger as he approached.
Finally. For the rest of us, you know.
I emphatically decline. You're not my type at all. Is all the law of casualty?
Causality.
Causality. You know what? Let's move on. Basic instinct, act and react.
They're gonna get married.
Well then. You don't mind.
Small smile played across the lips as she held the teacup delicately in her hand.
She whips it back from his face.
Wait.
She cocked her head with a sign. Oh, it threw the cup as hard as she could at the wall. Oh. What the? Hey, what are you doing, my little white rabbit?
I hate this kind of tea.
What are you doing? Specify?
She's making a point or something.
I don't understand.
Imagine we are at the coffee shop, just any normal, everyday cafe. I sit down and I order some tea.
Whoops!
Now, further imagine that I replied, yes, I would like milk tea, please.
Oh, she didn't specify.
In this case, along with my tea, they bring me a small container of milk, yes? But this is not for me. I am among those who prefer the milk to be part of the process from the outset. The fragrance is just so overwhelmingly sweet that way. Adding milk or lemon right before you drink is like dousing your fries with ketchup, mere condiments. Whenever looking for a cafe, I first review their menu to see if it offers the proper style of milk tea. And I cannot acknowledge any milk tea that does not add the milk during the brewing process.
Awfully picky.
This is a wonderful waltz down tea lane.
If I had to describe our shared reaction to what we just heard. Celeste, have you ever heard the saying, just be grateful for what you get? I have to go with wide-eyed bewilderment. I went to all that trouble to make you that tea, and you wanted me to go even farther? Yes,
I realize it can be a bit of a hassle. Even in cafes that offer proper milk tea, it is always more expensive than simple tea with milk.
Celeste became Gordon Ramsay really freaking quick.
It's fucking wrong!
Yeah.
Where's the sauce?
It takes more time to prepare, surely, but why even bother creating a menu if you're not going to offer the highest level of quality?
You don't
get any of this relevant?
Donkey? Well, we don't actually have a menu.
That does not matter. Hurry up and bring me what I asked for, swine.
How about you make it yourself, then?
I can't place the country, the accent.
Okay, your little piggy will bring it right out.
What is happening right now?
I'm confused.
I do so love coercion.
How about you make it yourself, then?
You were like a totally different person right just now.
Kind of, yes.
Yeah, shit. You really went psycho there.
I knew there were more of her when I first met her. I'd hate to have her as an enemy. Oh, whoops! I keep accidentally tapping it twice. The dining hall door flew open and one of the late arrivals came coming in. But... Bad news, everyone. There's a mystery afoot.
Oh, God.
Huh? What happened?
It would seem Bayakua refused to leave his room. Probably not good. I stood there pressing his elbow over and over, but he never showed himself.
I mean, he's kind of an asshole.
Maybe he just
really
wasn't
here?
There. I'd like to think so, but I'm worried something might have happened to him.
Oh, jeez, have we lost another one already?
What he meant by that? He didn't have to say anything else. Everyone understood exactly what that might mean. You donut!
What?
It might be a good idea if we all split up and go look for
you.
Ah, I was just about to suggest the same thing.
What's your problem?
I'm not trying to one-up everyone.
What the frick is your problem, Papa?
Okay, then I'll go check his room one more time. I'm just gonna keep on hammering that button until I get a response.
How about go in?
I can't.
Oh, no.
Very well. The rest of us can go check the rest of the building.
Yeah, before he's, you know, too late.
He nearly did the stoner voice.
Dot.
Anyway, we have to just do our best to find Byakuya. I have a feeling he's dead, a weird feeling. So where might Byakuya have gone?
I don't think it's that weird of a feeling.
Maybe he went to go check out the second floor of the school again.
Well, there's still Celeste to talk to figure out what the hell that whole tea episode was about.
Oh, it's B to talk to people, right?
No, A.
Celeste, aren't you gonna help look for Byakuya?
I have not had my tea yet.
Is that seriously your biggest concern, Celeste?
To be fair.
Yes.
Huh?
Until my thirst is satisfied, I have no urge to do anything.
Celeste, you're making me mad and you use it on Celeste.
You're in a hurry. Feel free to motivate Tafumi to move faster.
How about just do it yourself then? I keep accidentally tapping it twice. Aren't you being kind of selfish? Yes.
Well, let's go to the dining room and
go
see.
Go into the kitchen, yeah. See that?
Slap Miss Piggy into right making the tea faster.
Miss Piggy?
You write fanfics, right?
Oh, Mr. Naiki, what's going on?
Well, nobody's seen by Acura this morning, so they've all decided to go look for
him. What? That's not good at all. However, this little piggy needs to... I have a holy edict to deliver a proper milk tea to my master.
What?
To bless this undeserving swine is such an honor. I will serve you with all my heart and soul.
He said straight up, while you were out talking to women,
down.
I was studying
put
the blade.
Tea down. I said put down the dang tea.
He's got that energy going on.
Oh, okay. Good luck with that. I assume he's created some creepy alternate reality form.
Yeah.
That's for sure.
He's a warrior for feminism.
I need to go to the bathroom.
Okay.
This dude's got some real,
okay, while you were out talking to women, I was studying the blade energy.
Alright, well, just put the...
Alright, I need to go to the bathroom. I'll be back.
Okay.
You freaking donut.
This guy's like a warrior for feminism type. Like, just the dialogue. Like, I don't really think they need a warrior. Okay.
Jack just went to go to the bathroom, so here. I'm gonna go to the second floor.
I have Natasha Bedingfield stuff in my head.
Feel the rain on your skin?
Oh, that thing looks like some monkey, rabbit, human mix.
Yeah.
What is up with that mouth?
So,
let me show you something. Okay. Ow, you're crushing my arm.
Sorry.
So you go to X to bring up your handbook.
Okay.
And then go to map. And then you use the bumpers. So there's this Hope's Peak second floor, and then you just hit A to teleport.
Talk to Kyoko?
Yep. Kitty, kitty.
Hey.
So you've got to come here too.
Huh?
So...
If you think about what Byakuya said, or was so interested in yesterday, you can probably guess where he is right now,
right? Yeah, the freaking archive.
What was it Byakuya was interested in again? Where do I go? What do you want me to do?
Library.
Oh.
Whoops, you left.
Nope.
Let's go outside. Right behind you. Great.
Keep going down that hall.
Aim for the green. Put turn left in 551 now.
Sorry, I'm not really good with this.
It takes a little bit of this.
And open the door to the library and look inside. I cried out in some surprise. Byakuya? Oh god! Of all the things I'd imagined, there's most definitely wasn't one of them.
She's just what? Reading.
What are you doing?
I'm fishing. What does it look like?
Not much!
I like him.
Yeah.
I'm trying to read, so if you could be quiet.
You're
reading
the
book.
Oh.
Sorry.
Can you
just go down to the dining hall early?
Wait,
I guess so.
No.
Oh, they had a duel maker.
Everyone's super worried. We've all been looking for you. Who asked you to do that? Because we're all supposed to meet up in the morning and eat together. And we made a promise. Can't I get a second to be so quiet around here?
Byakuya snapped his book shut and closed it up. Smooth and silent as a shadow. Meanwhile, the others must have heard me yell and started showing up one after another.
Byakuya, so this is where you've been hiding.
What are you doing here, man?
We were very concerned.
Well, you had no reason to be. I was just reading. I've never read such a coarse novel before, but it might just prove useful at some point. Oh, please don't tell me it was Catcher in the Rye. A mystery novel.
Sweet.
Appropriately, ahahahaha, Shannon Waterfall Takara Waddell.
What?
I'm sorry, what?
I don't... What?
Lucas, do you need your reset pin again?
Wait, so are you going to use what you're learning there to betray us?
Yes, very confused.
Are you confused yet? Yes.
Don't be stupid.
Yeah.
It's just something to keep in mind.
Yeah, what?
If I decide to fight, of course we'll come up with something original.
Yeah, it's kind of scaring me right now.
Ooh. Otherwise, this game of ours would be totally boring, right? It's not often you get to take part in such a high-stakes, high-tension activity. So,
activity.
If you're going to do it, you have to make sure it's entertaining. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
His words sent a chill down his spine. There was an undeniable smile on his face as he spoke. He looked like he was actually enjoying himself. Enjoying this deranged killing game. Hold on, I'll go reset my feet, synthesizers.
What the fuck do you mean, game? That's fucked up. But it is a game. It's a game of life or death, which can have only one winner. That's all there is to it.
He's not wrong.
He is right. It's a zero-sum game.
Huh?
He's a part of game theory, a mathematical model. In game theory, what we are going through now is called a zero-sum game.
What, Dad?
Huh?
Oh.
In this type of game, in order for one person to gain something, another must necessarily lose something. In other words, it is a situation in which participants must compete for position or resources.
You mean like a kind of elimination match?
Entrance exams, sports tournaments, job openings, most social interactions fall into this category. Everyone must scramble to obtain something which is limited. For you to succeed, someone else must fail. This also applies to the school life we have been subjected to here. In this case, our limited resource is that only one of us can successfully become the Black Mage.
So this game was designed from the beginning to force one of us to try and defeat all the others. Actually, you just have to defeat one.
But that can't be what they had in mind.
Absolutely.
This is why adaptation is so crucial. If those who want to escape were to disappear, there would be no reason to continue playing the game.
But why would I want to stop playing? It's so much fun.
What's fun about this? He smiled again as he spoke. The smile was filled with evil intent. It twisted his face into something not human.
Yeah, he's got his
face. It sounds as if you do not acknowledge even the possibility that you might lose, am I right?
Of course.
You do not speak like the others. Exactly what I would expect from the Togami heir apparent.
Just normal arrogance, isn't it?
You talk like that, but what if you end up dead?
Oh, hey, that worked.
I won't. It simply isn't possible. Who the fuck do you think you are?
Hey, bud, no, we're gonna stop with that.
You know, I still just can't believe it.
What?
Believe what? That an uneducated, brain-dead, useless piece of garbage like you has survived this long. I'm gonna fucking kill you! Like I said, I'm gonna die. You keep saying that, but...
Oh!
Do not bother arguing with him. For him, the concept of losing simply does not exist. He is the ultimate affluent progeny member. Boy raised to succeed from the day he was born. He considers victory his destiny, and he has lived his life accordingly. Tests and challenges are merely ways for him to stand victorious. even if it is a life and death situation. Is that not so, Byakuya?
At least one of you seems to understand.
Is it because I am the same as you? Games are meant to be won?
It is because...
Are you trying to suggest we're on the same level? Close that vulgar mouth of yours.
Oh my god!
Damn. Oh, well, I do apologize.
Anyway, let me just say this to all of you. You all need to try harder. If an opponent isn't going to give it their best, where's the fun for me?
No.
That's a terrible way to look at it.
Yes, kind of.
What? Hmm?
You're kind of scaring me!
This isn't a game. Our lives are on the line, you know. To kill your own friends is
horrific.
It's horrific.
Friends? Who decided that? We're not friends. No, quite the opposite. We're in competition. We're enemies. But what? Stop trying to force your contradictions on me and just accept what I'm telling you. Yes? If you have something to say, say it. Otherwise, keep your mouth closed.
I'm sorry.
Hey, shithead! You get off on bullying people that can't fight back? You want to try that on me? So, you're back to pretending to be friends, huh? And how long do you think that's going to last?
What's the problem, dude?
Fuck you! What? Is that all you can say? It's unfortunate you would waste your breath on such empty gibberish. That's it, you're fucking dead.
Just calm down.
Very tempting right now.
I am calm. No, you're not!
How is this calm?
Exactly.
Anyway, I don't have any intention of working with the rest of you any longer. To cooperate during an elimination game is, well, frankly, it's a waste of time, and I hate wasting my time.
Waste of time?
Engaging in friendly group meals is out of the question. Someone could easily poison our food. And I'd rather not become part of the Last Supper just yet. Quit talking like you're in a fucking movie or something. All I'm saying is that, ultimately, you're all free to do whatever you want on your own. Goodbye.
Without a second glance back, Byakuya left. There wasn't anything we could do to keep him from going. His way of thinking was just beyond anything the rest of us could even comprehend.
Was he serious about all that?
He sounded pretty serious.
He was, without a doubt.
Well, fuck him then.
But what he said, he might not necessarily.
No, he's in survival mode.
Yeah, he's in complete survival. He did not kill anybody.
I mean, can you say for sure someone won't poison our food?
I mean, you can't really say. For sure.
Hey, come on, you too, Toko.
Anyway, well, it's not like anyone would care even if I was gone, right?
That's true.
Yeah, kind of.
That's true.
Actually, I bet you all want me gone. You all think I'm disgusting.
That was happening.
None of us think that.
You just think you don't think that.
No, I kind of do, to be honest.
I know some people like to play the victim, but this is just totally out there.
You think I don't know, but I do. You want me gone.
I mean, kind of. You aren't wrong.
I'm sure the rest of you want the same thing, don't you?
She's crazy. She's literally crazy. Hey, Toko, wait!
Just let her go. Once she gets going like that, there's nothing you can say to her.
What the heck is her problem? Ultimately, our breakfast meeting came to an end without answering any questions. Everyone headed back to the
rooms. I mean, I can definitely see where Byakuya is coming from.
I can see it, yeah.
Making friends in this type of situation
is not easy.
It is, yes, but...
I mean, your natural human instinct to not want to kill people...
I know who I want to kill.
It's also just not that. It's just you didn't have to be so arrogant and so
right.
whatever. So
I know
like,
who
you know
I want
what?
To kill.
I would feel better just
sure.
doing this
especially
on my own.
Especially in a kill someone, get away from it type situation.
Mm-hmm.
You probably don't want to become public asshole number one.
Yeah. Yeah. The other thing, too, though, is that, you know, it's a life or death thing. However, in a life or death situation, alliances tend to be made. And people do tend to group up.
But this is like Survivor, right?
Yeah.
Ultimately, only one can
ultimately,
win.
Only one. But
so,
at the beginning, when there's a lot of people, being in groups can help.
Right, but then you grow close to people.
Yeah.
And then it becomes that much harder.
Yeah.
You know? So,
I'm
just saying, I see what he's doing.
Jeez, I'm tired already. But I don't have time to take even one day off. I need to get myself going.
Free time. So who do you want to go talk to? We can go to the store and go buy something, go talk to someone. You want to go take a look at the store and see what they have?
Sure.
I'd like to make friends with Kyoko.
You gotta move over until you see the... Oh, okay, that works too.
Sorry.
Yeah, Kyoko.
Kyoko, Sugara?
Sakura?
Sakura. And,
Alright, so where do you want to go first?
The store.
Anyone else?
That's the laundry.
I'm kind of digging Hero. You're on the wrong floor.
Yeah.
Oh.
Remember I showed you how to teleport?
Oh, yeah.
Next.
X.
Map.
A.
And then the bumpers. I believe it's...
Oh,
no.
It's on the first floor.
On the first floor.
Oh. Dormitory?
Main area. Oh, no, it's a dormitory, so go. Keep going. There.
Okay. Where's the store?
Back that way.
Oh, back
that way. That way, yep. It's over there.
Yeah, the brown door.
Yeah, let's see if it'll let us in.
I haven't actually been in here yet.
Let's see who's in here. Oh!
Okay.
I like
oh.
this.
Press Y.
It's, this. Would you like to try your hand against the almighty Mono Mono machine?
I'm guessing that's a gambling thing where you can earn more coins. Let's just take a look at the other stuff first before.
Mm-hmm. All
right,
right
give it a shot.
Okay, go ahead, give it a shot.
Alright, let's give it a shot. What am I doing?
No idea.
Okay.
Just one.
I'm trying to...
There we go.
Ooh.
Ooh. Cell phone?
Oh, looks like some sort of handheld game. Alright, so let's get out of here. Let's just check out everything.
Okay.
We got something going on down here.
Yep, this is definitely the school store. But there's all kinds of stuff here I wouldn't expect to find in a normal school store.
So if that was a handheld game?
Yeah, check it. Like,
we can give it to Haifumi.
Oh, yeah, because
yeah.
he likes handheld games. Oh,
there's something over there, too. Oh.
This vending machine doesn't seem to take any money, so I guess we can drink as much as we want.
Open bar!
Kenny's looking at it. Maybe I should start beating up on it. What?
Jeez, Makoto.
Haven't you seen that video of the coke machine falling on that thing?
Maybe that's how we get gifts.
What, this?
So, that thing?
It must be, because...
Yeah, nothing else really did anything, so we want to try a few more coins in this thing?
Sure. How many coins do I have, though?
90-something.
Very good.
Give her a shot!
Should we go ahead and do, like, what, 5?
Yeah, sure. 5 coins.
I got another ring.
Okay, so the more coins you feed into it, I think
the
better
item
quality
you
item you get.
Another? Or no? Sure. Another 5?
Sure.
We have a bunch, so we can just keep going as much as we want.
Oh,
like a book?
Ooh, a book.
I think Haifumi would like that. Depending on what it is, though.
Haifumi would like the gaming console.
Yeah.
We
better. Just do like 3 or 4 points this time.
What?
Maybe you have a limited number of goes.
Maybe.
Mm.
I can't go again.
Alright, well.
So let's take a look at our inventory and see what we have.
Okay. X.
Presents.
Love
status ring.
Wear it on your right hand. You're looking for love.
And you click on it.
On your left. You found it. On both. Well, that's asking for catastrophe.
Catastrophe. So if you're looking for love, you wear it on your right hand. If you found love, you wear it on your left.
Keep going. We've already looked at them.
If you wear it on both, it means you found love, but you're
the
still looking for more.
The newest popular portable game system.
It has, hold on, it has a high-def touchscreen. It can also play music and videos. Big for the perfect all-in-one media machine.
Okay.
So is that something Haiku you would like?
You can also just use the bumpers.
Oh, that's true. Oh, a thick book that has hints and codes for every game ever released.
That's another Haifumi gift.
A must
so it's
have
a strategy guide.
I'm wondering, give him that, or the
tips and tips?
Do you think the tips and tricks book, or the handheld?
He'd like both of them.
So how?
I can't think of anyone else that's in the video.
Schoolcraft. Proof that you cleared the prologue.
Yeah, you can't give that to anybody.
Oh, spare bat? That's what we got from Leon. That is now deceased.
Spare bat?
Yeah.
Is there a way
despair, not spare.
Is there a way we can give both to Haifumi? Or no?
I don't know.
We'll find out.
I'm hoping we can get a few more gifts.
That bad. It could either be your murder weapon or your defense weapon.
I mean, you could try leaving the room and coming back.
I kind of want to give him a fun plane. I'm sure he'd really like that.
I thought it was pretty clear how you're supposed to leave. Find someone, isolate them, kill them, and get away with it.
But they're like, there has to be a way out of here. There has to be a way out of here, but I don't.
I mean, granted, I would be like that too, but looking from a completely emotionless standpoint, that appears to be the only way out.
Yeah.
Okay, I kind of want to give him the fun plane for now. So do I just click on it?
And I'm kind of seeing...
No, you've got to back out of here.
Oh.
The other guy's point of view, it's a kill or be killed situation. Friends are kind of a waste of time.
Yeah.
But, like, at the same
Let's go
time,
find our friend Haifumi. See, let's check around this entire... I don't think they can really hear anything.
That's alright. Just...
No, this mic is really sensitive, so I'm pretty sure they can hear me.
So where are you going to try and find him?
I guess I could look in my map and, like, see where everyone is. Hallway 2F, there's 1F, so teleport, because I think we can.
Second floor. Yep, there he is.
Oh, Mr. Naive, funny meeting you here. A salute to you. Salute, I just saluted, did you see? That was a Haifumi ultimate salute. Zam, what is this guy going on about?
I don't know.
Is he drunk?
Don't want to hang out with Haifumi? Sure.
Is that just how he always is?
Yes.
Cosplayers these days are totally ignorant of the origin, the history, the significance of their hobby. And if you don't know how, and if you don't know your history, you can never have a complete cosplay experience.
Alright.
So, Mr. Naegi, prepare for a gloriously detailed history of the cosplay world, now in 1955.
Wow.
Oh my. I listened to Haifumi's half-obsessed ranting for way too long. Haifumi and I grew a little closer to that. Closer to wanting to kill him.
Say yes, definitely.
Yes, definitely.
What?
What would you like to give
him? They hung out with Haifumi. He went on a rant about cosplayers.
Yeah, I've got a whole cosplay history. Reggie's in.
Can I stop it?
Yep.
One
point.
We haven't given him the tips and tricks, but... we're trying to decide what you think he would want more.
Both.
Oh, God,
well,
I actually...
Just give him one thing, and next time you see him, give him the other.
Let's give him tips and tips. Why? There's a button to give him. I was once
Bruises Ubermensch, but Mr. Naiki has awakened my heart to the power of friendship.
Alright.
May I call you my master?
No.
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 No. What is thy bidding, my master?
No.
No.
Seeing and I feel so pleased with something I gave him makes me happy. Yeah, a bit
but
too
also
happy.
Disturbed.
The cat of
the ring. What are we giving the ring to?
I see quality in you, Mr. Naiyagi. True quality. And that's why I decided to present to you my lecture on the nature of fanfiction. No!
This guy is creepy.
If you're going to be friends, you must be fully informed. I will permit no fanfic bigotry whatsoever. I don't think I have any fanfic bigotry. I mean, I don't really know anything about that kind of geeky stuff anyway.
I like fanfiction.
See, there it is! To you, fanfic equals geeky, right? But is that all that word is worth? Huh? Did I say something wrong? But that's okay. Because I take the word geek as a compliment. For you, see, there's nobody on earth so full of knowledge as a geek.
Yes,
in a sense, a geek is like an expert. That's right, a total expert.
I enjoy fanfiction, but...
There are the weird ones.
If I were to like delve into it as a full time thing, I'd want to go with profic.
Yeah,
like actual professional writers.
Well, what the difference between fanfiction and profiction is fanfiction, you can like post it to forums and stuff.
Yeah.
And get followings. Profiction is
they write the shit.
You're hired to write actual novels in a universe, like Star Trek novels or whatever, and it's okayed by the franchise itself and then published.
Yeah.
And so.
A successful musician must necessarily be a music geek. A good movie director is a movie geek, you see? It's those experts, those geeks, who open up the world to others. So when you say that writing fanfic is geeky, you're recognizing us as true experts. Okay, so what exactly is
I can't tell. Is he angry? Is he
no, he's not angry. He's just being passionate.
Ooh, super direct question.
For the win.
For the win. Basically, we have all different kinds of stores and events, right? These are where the Holy Warriors sell their own stuff based on games, comics, anime, everything. And the stuff that people make is fanfic. Comics are the most common creation. But it also includes games, music, and even merchandise.
So now they've made a mistake here.
By the way, there's a name for when a group of fanfic creators come together. Specifically, it's any organized group that comes together to release their work. A group that comes together to release their
convention?
Work. Circle.
Square, circle, menagerie.
Circle.
Circle?
No.
Are you sure?
You're guessing. You're new to it.
Is it a circle? It sure is. Of course you knew that. I mean, it's only common sense. I certainly hope you don't expect me to explain such common sense topics every time. Well, like I said, I don't know too much about this stuff. This goes well beyond I don't know too much. But I guess I can't blame you. The propaganda never touches on that. So the fanfic ambassador, by the time I'm done with you, you'll be itching to buy a premium pass to the next fanfic con.
See, they're confusing fanfic with profic.
Yeah.
You can't sell fanfic.
No.
But
fanfiction
you can sell
just something you write.
Right?
Fanfiction
obviously,
is
he's excited. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it for your next lesson.
I don't know. Maybe the definition's different in Japan.
I can't wait to see what the future has in store for the two of us. Kind of scared to see what the future has in store for the two of us.
Yeah. A little bit.
Yeah, he's definitely a bit unnerving.
He's a bit much.
He's unlocked the skill handiwork. Keep yourself on the path.
He's got his skill.
I mean, I like him, but he can get super passionate.
29-9.
After we were done, I decided to head back to my room for a while.
Bangity twang twang.
What are you doing?
Making noise with my first
clearly.
Yeah.
Still
plenty of time left. You just shouldn't be around here. I should end out. I should check, Hatsumi's report card. How do I... Oh, report card. Name, Hatsumi Yamada. Ultimate fanfic creator. As the ultimate fanfic creator, it's my job to spread the gospel of fanfic.
I want to start going to cons, giving lectures on the power of fanfic. Skills, handiwork.
Okay, just go out of the room and I'll find someone else to talk to.
I found this way. Just exiting. Alright. Did I check out my map? See where one is? Talk to the church.
Wait, you have a map that magically reveals everyone's location?
Yep.
That's kind of creepy.
So Celeste is...
at hallway in the main range of, like, around where we are.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody's there.
Where's,
I'm gonna ask someone for in
the
room, so...
Well,
I guess we can...
Well, you can go
you
find Sakura's
like,
room and just pause on her doorbell.
Yeah, but I kind of want to talk to Celeste.
You only get one other person.
Yeah.
Oh, I guess...
I was thinking Sakura or Kyoko.
Yeah.
Kyoko would make a good ally.
Let's find Kyoko's room.
Right there.
Oh. Oh, really? No, that's Taka.
Oh, no.
Taka.
Yes.
That's
Taka.
Look at,
okay.
Press, Y.
Kyoko is...
Does anyone know if Taka's okay?
Kyoko.
Okay. I mean, don't click on her door though. Click on the buzzer.
I think it'll probably tell you, oh, I can't go in there.
Okay, oh. To click on the door.
I guess I should press the doorbell.
What's the matter? Are you keeping an eye on me? Don't worry, I'm not going to kill anyone.
Should I
drink
a Coca-Cola? Yes.
It's true. I was just about to head to the dining hall to get something to drink.
Well, she's getting a hard jack on that.
Yeah, definitely.
Did you want to come with me?
No dude about it, eh?
No, I went to the dining hall and drank some tea with Kyoko.
Tea.
Look risky,
isn't it? That ain't tea, that's Irish coffee.
Want to give Kyoko a present?
We don't have anything
to
look over there.
We don't really have anything that should be interesting.
Not really, no?
Here's the Nintendo DS.
I'm not sure.
I'm guessing you're just going to be like, get another book that's like mystery related or you know something like a magnifying glass or something like that. That's right?
So not really, no? But I don't think GB is in the DS.
Are you scared of Nintendo? Being trapped in a place like this?
Who wouldn't be? Of course I'm scared. Being trapped in this insane school?
Correct. Oh, that's good.
That's good?
So... fear is proof that your imagination is functioning. Frankly, I feel bad for anyone who can't feel fear. Without imagination, you can never deduce which action to take next.
But what about you? You seem totally calm. You don't act afraid at all.
I'm scared too, of course. I simply hide my emotions. There's no advantage to be gained from letting others see what you feel.
Hide? Huh?
What I mean is, I'm not as foolishly open as you are.
Foolishly open?
Also, the fear I experience is a little different from yours, I imagine.
Well, what do you mean?
So...
you're afraid of what you might lose, right?
Correct.
But I'm afraid of what I've already lost.
Sorry, I don't understand.
I know.
She didn't bother answering any further. She just turned.
Goodbye. I'd like to believe that her dad has the same hair color.
Mm.
And he's just got this forest of lilac belly button hair.
Well, we're still getting
why
into
would
the
you ever give anybody that
lilac hair coming out of his ears?
Oh, wait, maybe by this report card, it'll tell us what you do.
Worse ear hair problem than Vlad?
Shoulder
you
hair?
That added back to my room
for oh, one. That thing?
That is a thing, yeah. Back hair.
It's nighttime.
Don't.
Okay. I can't even be bothered to read it anymore. Another day gone. But even though today is over, this game definitely isn't. How long is this gonna keep going?
I don't know.
Until one person makes it out alive. All the stress and anxiety kept me from falling asleep until late in the night.
Yep.
What?
Whatever's gonna keep going, I have a tendency to stare.
That's right.
What? Can't help it. I just gave with intensity. The other day I rode my bike to the train station. I was in the bathroom just looking at myself in the mirror. Oh god. Okay.
I think you skipped a little early.
Oh. But I didn't want to read anyway. Screw that.
I hate that
bear. Me too.
Do you imagine waking up and going to bed with that every night?
Oh, good morning, everyone.
Oops, sorry, bud.
I just want to kill you, but I can't. Because then I'd explode. Or get spears in me.
You're still alive?
I think he's still watching. He just hasn't said anything in a while.
I mean, I do that sometimes where I say some stuff and then I just swat.
Maybe you fell asleep out.
Dining hall? We should probably go to the dining hall. See if anybody's in here. Probably.
Well, everybody's in here. That's where we're supposed to meet.
When's the breakfast meeting? Same as always, but...
I don't remember. 37?
Okay. Is this... Everyone feels a little small.
My ex
and
I
Toko had stormed off yesterday, and it wasn't so surprising they had come today.
That's true.
Even the table was bigger somehow.
I assume that is because three people are dead and two are abstaining.
Yeah, with five people missing, I guess it would feel kind of empty.
Still, I know Ayaki is whatever, but shouldn't we go check on Toko?
I don't know. She's super annoying.
Yeah, she is, kind of.
How can you be so cold? You are like a piece of rock candy.
Yesterday, he just manipulated and terrified a fat kid into making a tea, you weirdo.
What? No rock candy is cold. It's sweet.
It's still not hot.
Anyway, Bakia is the real problem. If we don't keep an eye on him, he might really kill someone. You can see it in his eyes. We got no choice. Get some rope. We're gonna have to keep him bound and gagged.
What?
That's
going a little
much.
Overboard. He's right. This situation is nothing scarier than when old Allie turns loose king.
When an ally.
Ally. Words are hard. It's just like when we were kids and someone would go crazy at sports day or whatever.
You're a kid. What the fuck are you talking about? You gonna use the rope to do tug of war or something? Idiot.
I'm not an idiot. You're an idiot.
This is exactly what they want. Everybody's fighting.
Nice comeback, Taka.
Who are you calling stupid?
You.
You. Well, what's wrong with you, Hero? You don't look so great.
Well, I'm just going to love.
Self-loathing.
What does that mean?
Hating yourself.
Huh? Self-loathing?
Well, after what Bianca said to me yesterday, I just got so nervous I locked up. I couldn't see anything.
Mom,
Mondo ended up having to help me out, and even he said I was someone who can't fight back.
Aww.
I hate how weak I am.
Yeah, that kind of unintentionally stung,
so
didn't it?
So Mondo made you depressed.
What? How is it my fault? I wasn't trying to be mean. Besides, girls are just naturally weak anyway.
Sakura will have something to disagree with you on that.
Not trying to be mean, huh, Mondo?
Yeah, isn't Sakura the really buff lady? She should probably smash her face.
Straight checked. Are you crying?
Yeah, I know.
It's because you were screaming like a lunatic.
Hey, come on, don't cry. It's my fault, okay? I won't yell at you anymore.
Really? Not sure I can believe that.
Yay. Well, maybe your mouth should look weird. Just shut up. I got it. I'll make you a promise as a man.
Oh my god.
Promise as a man?
Yeah, that's right.
Maybe I mentioned this before, but...
I'm a man.
Ever since I was a kid, I've had a penis.
Did he really just...
No.
There was one thing my brother told me over and over again. Cut your fucking hair. No. He said that no matter what, a real man always keeps his promises. That's what he left me.
Left you?
Oh, yeah. My brother's dead.
Okay.
I'm Batman.
Oh, I see.
That's true.
Anyway, I don't want to talk about it. Don't want to make all you guys cry.
Maybe yourself.
Yo.
Anyway, so you can trust me when I make that promise. So don't you go cry anymore.
Okay.
This guy's such an asshole.
But I really like him.
I kind of like Mondo.
Yeah, me too.
He's got a weird
He's
sense of honor.
He's got an anger issue, but yeah, he does have a weird sense of honor.
That's why I kind of...
His anger issue is pretty sexist, but other than that...
That's why I'm kind of worried for him. Whenever we make him mad.
Shit, sure.
But I still don't like how I am right now. I have to get stronger.
Oh,
If I'm so weak, anything can make me cry. That's not good.
Still, don't stress out too much for having to get stronger.
No, I want to get stronger. Maybe I should start working out. In that case, I would be happy to help you out anytime.
Is that, Allie?
Whoops.
What?
He just closed his balls in a drawer?
This man no pooping pieces.
Shut up, you.
Oh, finally cracked a smile, huh?
Sure, yeah. Everyone, thank you.
Looks like your hero's gotten some life back. Yeah, man. Keep helping each other out like this, we're bound to get out of this crappy place sooner or later.
The swimmer,
which means
right?
Killing each other. I mean...
Aoi is the swimmer.
I mean...
Or Hino is the closer.
Someday, I'm sure.
I thought it was Aoi. I don't know how it was pronounced.
No.
Either way.
I don't know.
Doesn't matter.
Still, our biggest concern right now is the other two, who never showed up to breakfast. What can I do to try and understand those two better?
Kill them.
Sorry. That was supposed to be in my head thought.
Okay, so what I should do today?
Go try and buy more stuff to give to people, and then go find two people.
Ah, yes. The easiest way to make friends.
Find them things.
Yeah.
That's the best. Oh.
It's not shallow at all.
So we gotta go down. Back
you
down
just
to the
took
first
my hat.
Floor.
Okay, anyway.
I love how the go-to way to make friends in video games is just keep giving them things until they like you.
Because I kind of want to get to the store.
Yeah, it's
that's
like...
the dormitory room, so...
Games
so
teach you that anybody can be won over with
enough
gifts.
The next
gifts.
Tab, though. There we go. Oh. Well, we don't need a second floor. We're in the gym. There.
Go here?
Yep.
Store should be right freaking here.
Yep.
I'm learning.
On the left, Gov.
Okay, wanna try out this machine again?
Sure.
It's a machine, I'm not sure what it's called. Mono.
But wait, there's a learn more about it tab.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, I already...
Well.
I wanna do... 5 coins? Okay. Let's see what we get.
Oh god.
Oh Jesus.
What'd you get?
A baseball.
Can't
give that to anybody.
Because, the person that we
okay,
could
back
get...
out, back out.
Go oh, God. Did Monokuma kill him with baseballs for irony?
Monokuma is an asshole.
Is that what happened?
Yeah, he was surrounded by pitching machines.
Yeah, no, I know that's how he died, but was Leon, like, super into baseball?
Leon was,
he was
the ultimate baseball
star. That's just, wow.
During
okay.
his stay here at Oak Peak Academy, you'll find coins scattered throughout the school. These mono coins are treasures valued by kings and thieves alike.
Yeah, okay.
You can get the handbook menu to see how many mono coins you currently have. Well, I'm not going to give that to Leon if he's still alive.
You better
chance
you have
getting something new. Okay.
Something you can actually use.
So early on, we can just keep using a single coin.
Yeah.
Until we start getting repeats.
I wonder what Makoto was thinking when he got that baseball. He's like, oh my god.
Sure, give it a shot and just use one coin.
One coin?
Yeah, it doesn't affect the quality. It has to do with repeats.
The music's nice.
Gold. Yeah. Number one? Okay. What is that?
A bracelet?
Is that something Sayaka would
have? See, because the repeat number's
going up. Yeah, the repeat percent goes up. Whoa, keep going on. It's a 5% chance of a repeat.
What is that?
Oh.
We'll just have to look at all the stuff
out there.
Oh.
I thought it looked like a seat.
Yeah, one more. What is that?
That looks like a cassette tape.
Cassette tape.
How about one more? What?
I don't have a gambling problem.
Like, not at all.
Yeah. Well, it's not really gambling.
Let's just take a look at what we have, because then that way we can determine who we need.
More buying gifts than you are gambling.
No, I was just referring to Jack. You're like, I can do one more time.
I can afford one more.
Bracelet. A handcrafted item made with needle and thread. They say that once you put it on, it will never come off again.
Wait, sorry, what?
An everlasting bracelet. They say once you put it on, it will never come off again.
Wait, is this?
You already saw that.
Bracelet. Oh, a handcrafted
that. Yeah, we saw that, and the next one. Keep going.
Yeah, you keep switching back up to the top, Jack.
Oh, really?
Yes.
But why am I doing that?
I don't know.
I don't have a gambling problem at all. Oh, what is this?
Wallet.
No, come on!
Self-destructing cassette that... What? That might be Kyoko. Or something.
Once you record a message onto this, it sets up a chemical reaction that will destroy the tape a few seconds after it's played.
Seems like some spy shit that she'd be into.
What was the...
Well, that was Mr. Fast.
A baseball shaped robot.
Check it out anyway.
Oh, come on. What am I doing?
I don't...
What am I doing?
Use the directional buttons then.
Yeah, use the D-pad, dude, because...
This... Oh, hey, someone's ruined our screen. Oh, hello.
Well, hello, and welcome.
An arrowhead discovered from ancient ruins, fashioned from a meteorite. They say that getting pierced by it will give you the power to see demons.
Or you die.
Wouldn't that be good?
Toko?
No, I wouldn't want to give her that.
The bun flame?
Why, is she not too bright in the head?
Check out Mr. Skull? Fastball. And the crystal skull.
A skull carved with pure rock crystal. Something skulls like this were created hundreds of years ago. Perhaps with alien intervention and consider them poop arts.
Okay, that hero.
Yeah, that's
something that hero would have.
Mr.
Fastball.
It's probably for Leon, but...
Baseball shaped velocity measurement machine, yes.
Oh, whoops, I accidentally... God dang!
Dude, you suck.
Yeah, I do.
You spent 5 minutes navigating a menu to check, like... Three things.
Yeah,
oh, yeah, quality chinchilla cover.
A dark red seat cover. It's a fine design. It's intended for only the most elite queen. Would that be good for?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Well, who
Blue regards themselves
as... That's a bike thing, right?
Sorry.
Ooh!
What was the description of again?
Mondo.
Yeah.
Oh, Mondo, yes.
Yeah.
That we're gonna get...
What was the description of it again?
It's like a chinchilla motorcycle seat cover.
Yeah, I think we've
done
through all that.
Yeah, get that to Mondo. That sounds like his thing.
Alright, do you want to go and try and find Mondo for that?
I should mention, since there's some new people,
yeah.
All of these streams are archived on my YouTube channel, which is just Chris McNeil, which also happens to be my name, which is bizarre. It's not actually Ayndar. Fun fact.
That's because you would...
figured as much.
You would have needed to create an entire other Google account.
Okay. Well, let's see where Mondo is.
So this is episode 4. The other three are archived there, along with a bunch of other goodies.
Holy, yeah. Cool.
Because
cool.
I'm basically awesome.
That's
what my mom tells me.
Uh-huh.
Oh, so bored. Bored. I don't know how many times you said it. Bored.
I don't know.
Hell yeah.
Oh,
hell yeah, I'm totally down to kill some time with you.
Okay.
And some people.
I killed some people with Mondo. Oh, wait, that's my Mondo voice.
I killed some people with Mondo. Mondo and I grew a little closer today.
We touched tips.
Really?
Are you freaking serious, dude?
Oh my god.
Chinchilla.
The chinchilla?
Yeah.
I love the contrast between the games we're playing.
Also, if you like this, my co-host, yeah.
Yes.
My wife is Mosaic Owl. And this little fella here, Gamerbyrd23.
Give what?
Yeah. This thing is like super rare!
Awesome.
Hell yeah.
Don't mind if I do. Damn, I'm lucky as shit.
No.
Seeing Mondo is so pleased with something I gave him makes me happy.
Ooh, do we get it? Hey Makoto, what's your ride?
What did that mean?
I ride a bicycle?
It's a Toyota Corolla.
Oh, my ride?
Yeah, man, your hog, your chopper, your motorcycle.
Oh, I don't ride anything.
What? You're not a little kid anymore, right? And you still don't have a hog?
Not everyone has
I don't have
one.
Any kind of swine, sir. God, you're such a fucking dweeb.
Well, I'm sorry. I'll take that really super rare expensive thing back then.
Sorry?
Alright, man. I'm gonna educate you.
Oh, God. We have to learn about fanfic, and now we gotta learn.
A real man rides Kawasaki, okay? That's what I write. Oh, my God. This guy... Okay, I'm before I read this, let me just say...
This guy is literally the most toxic masculine.
This guy would be chased right out of the Delaware Friday the 13th rally every single time if he showed up on a freaking Kawasaki.
Why?
Because a real man rides a lowrider...
Really?
Yeah, touring bike. Something with guts.
What
is
it? Wait.
I'm dead. I want you to read this.
Shut up.
Okay.
Shut your face.
Okay, I'll read it.
No, that's okay. You ought to see it, man. The V-twins got that monster power. It's like you're dancing.
What?
Kind of sounds like this. Of course, it ain't just for anyone. You gotta have the skill to handle it.
You must really love your motorcycle.
Way too much. Hell yeah, I do. I'm a goddamn biker, ain't I? We're crazy as hell.
Clearly.
I would pay money to see a biker gang riding Kawasaki.
Yeah.
Japan.
It's gotta be a Japan thing.
Yeah, you're the leader of
Kawasaki's Japanese anyway, so.
Yeah, you're the leader of the biggest biker gang in Japan, right?
Damn straight. The Invincible Crazy Diamond Gang. You wanna come on a ride with us? The monster sound coming out of that straight pipe. Hot damn.
Straight pipe?
I have been
Come on, you gotta know what's straight.
It's getting harder
it's
and
like
harder.
When something's missing, right? That's why it makes a monster sound, like a pipe of smoke, and it's got more muffles.
It's got no muffler.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
It's when the motorcycle doesn't have a muffler, right?
Hell yeah.
So you did know. Good. Then that's next. Next time we ride, or then that's that. Next time we ride, you ride with us.
Which is gonna be when?
Man, that makes me think back to when I first started riding.
Can I just say, though, the fact that he takes the time to do his eyeliner and eyeshadow, like that's a commitment.
Shout out to Armadillo Head. My big bro used to ride too, you know? His name's Daya.
Daya
and Mondo. Together we were the Diamond Brothers. Oh, Diamondo, I get it. Why am I still talking about it? Everyone up and down the country knew us. Of course, I was always the cool one.
The Diamond Brothers? That sounds kind of incredible.
First time I went out, I ended up at the back of the pack.
Diamond Brothers? That's pretty crazy.
Eventually, the cops got on us. They surrounded me. I was in some tough shit, man.
Hey, damn it.
So I pulled over. When they came up to me, well, let's just say it was a massacre.
So you
a massacre? Man, Mondo, you must really be strong.
Of course. You can't wave the banner for a gang without that kind of strength. In a fight, they'll go for the leader first. Kill the leader of the pack, you know? That's why the other gangs come after me. So if you want to be leader of the pack, you gotta be a tough motherfucker.
Yo.
You'll see what I mean when we go on our first ride. Get ready for it.
If we go on our first ride. Actually, maybe it's better we don't get involved in that kind of thing. Like I said, I don't have a motorcycle. I don't even know how to drive.
Hell yeah.
Then you can ride with me.
Oh yeah.
Put your junk near my butt and hang on to my waist. It's totally straight.
Riding with Mondo, another game started getting first, right? No. No way.
Hell yeah.
Hey, I said get ready for it.
But we don't know what's gonna happen.
Damn, I am pumped. I can't wait to get out of here now.
Mondo,
I wanna wear you like a backpack, boy.
Mondo left. Apparently in a pretty good mood. I don't know what that means. I just... Crap, this is really bad. Even if I get out of here, I might still be in real trouble. One of the parkers went up to
That entire time, I was resisting the urge to make dick jokes, but you
did it.
Even when I stand up, I don't want you to let go. You just stay on like my little backpack.
So did you want to go and find Hero and give him that crystal skull?
Yeah.
Yeah.
First, I want to check Mondo's report card.
He's not, like, crazy aliens guy, is he?
He's crazy clairvoyant.
Oh, is he the dude with the weird hair?
Stay.
Like the really weird,
crazy
afro thing?
Oh, whoops.
Oh, he's all grayed out because he's dead.
Oh.
Okay, so his skill is giving us an extra skill point, which is pretty awesome.
Yeah. Ain't nobody can hold a candle to us. Feared and respected wherever we go. Daya, my bro, and me,
Mondo.
Japan. Together we're hard as diamond. We're the crazy diamond. Yeah, he's all grayed out because he's
dead.
You come to North America, they're riding Harleys and Indian.
Let's also find Hero.
Well, that finish off the bay.
About.
Okay, let's see.
Have I ever had, like...
Wait, before we do that, can we go to the warehouse that they kept talking about near the dorms, wherever that is?
But won't that finish off the day? I mean, you can always do it the next day, right?
I think we're gonna close up stream at the end of it.
Yeah, people are in their rooms right now, I think.
Okay.
So, we can either... Yeah, I mean...
Go to Hero's room.
Oh, he's probably in his room right now. Must
see him out right now.
Check the map.
Press Y.
Could be the one with the crazy ass hair. She was along the back wall. Right beside Hifumi's room. And what used to be Leon's room. And you go, wow, there's only two people left on that wall. Turn right.
Okay. Hero?
It's a hero.
How do I get out?
If I ever had like a ton of money and got into motorcycles,
yeah.
I would want an Indian motorcycle.
It must be out somewhere. Cause...
I don't think that company exists anymore.
They're all
Indian.
Oh, it's probably good on.
They're eating the kitchen.
Alright. I gotta just. You're on the same floor, so you can just get out of the map.
What am I doing?
Let me get you there?
Zoom in.
I'm here.
It's basically a super insensitive name, but they made it super awesome when it was over.
Yep, that way.
No, I don't get it. Like,
I saw it.
Dad's touring bike was a Suzuki. Japanese. Mm-hmm. Where the hell are they riding Kawasaki? Kawasaki makes the ninja.
He's in the kitchen, so you gotta go into that door.
It's like the what bike?
Lame.
Why is it
crotch lame? Crotch rocket.
What?
It's a crotch rocket. One of those ring, 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 ring. Well, well, Makoto, what's going on?
Hmm,
should I
go here for a while? Sure.
Well? You wanna grab a bite to eat in the dining hall? I'll teach you where all the best power spots are.
You taught me about
old. Oh, thank God it's gift up.
It probably won't, though, once you give him your gift.
Here, when I grew up.
A bunch of coffee.
Yes! I would like.
Crystal skull. You're saying I can have this? All of a sudden I feel invigorated. I feel awake. I feel like I like you.
Why, did you not like me before? What's happening?
Hey, Makoto, you know what I think? You and me meeting like this, it wasn't a coincidence. So I've got some good news for you. I'm gonna give you a psychic reading at a huge discount.
Well, it better be free, because I don't have any money.
A discount?
Normally, it's $1,000 for 2 hours. But for you, let's call it $900.
That's
$100 off, dude.
It's only a...
It's
only a $100 discount, and even that is way too expensive.
Don't be hey, come on! You should count yourself lucky that the ultimate clairvoyant is willing to tell your future.
But we don't have money! So, are you right pretty often?
I sure am. At the bare minimum, I've got a 20% chance of accuracy.
That's at the minimum?
20%? That sounds pretty sketchy.
What the heck? For real? Don't make that face. Didn't you hear what I said? 20% of the time, I'm right. Every time. That includes natural disasters, election results, you name it.
Just gave you a crystal skull.
Don't you realize how amazing that is?
Actually, that's terrible.
Okay, fine. I'll give you a special trial run. After all, I've already seen what the future has in store for you.
What? When did you see it?
You won't believe what I saw. It would appear that the mother of your children and the mother of my children are the same woman.
What?
Is that what he said?
I repeat, then I don't like it.
Doesn't matter if you don't like it. That's just the way it is.
20% accuracy, you said?
At least.
I prayed everything's holy that you're going to sleep me wrong.
Nana, Since that was a special trial run, I'm afraid I can't apply the discount. That'll be $1,000, please. Don't worry, you can pay me after we get out of here.
Yeah, okay, I'll get right on
that. But we need to get the money first. Wait, hold on. This is where we are going to be right, right?
If you like, I can do a reading right now to see whether my reading is right or not. Naturally, additional fees will apply. Think about it, okay? Let me know as soon as you're ready for my services.
I've read everything that is holy that you're wrong.
Do I have enough in my bank account to take all the crack at it? No, I can't bring myself to pay for something like that. You see how people could fall into that kind of cycle, though. That was close. Please, whoever's listening, I'm begging you. Whatever else happens, don't let him
know. I love how that freaked him out more than just like anything else.
Camp Death.
Please, I pray to everything that is holy and true.
Lost in thought.
We're all gonna head back to my room for a little while. Are you sure we should end the stream here?
Yeah, it's been 2 hours.
Yeah, and it's
getting late.
It's late.
I kinda wanna go just one more day.
No, it takes too long.
The problem is there might be something that happens that extends the day.
Okay.
It's like you know how sudden the last deaths were, right? Every day you go, something new might happen, right?
I have a feeling something new is about to happen. Because this has never happened before.
What is? Oh, the fact that
I better go to the dining hall before I turn in.
I just wanted to get something to eat. Now I'm about to get roped into something like this. Actually, no, because I'm already roped in. Hey, Makoto! Perfect time! What was going on?
Hey, damn it. I have a favor to ask.
A favor?
Yep.
I have a bad feeling about this. Should I talk to him?
Talk to whoever you want.
Have to talk to him.
Come on, Makoto. You gotta be our witness.
Witness? To what?
This guy's been talking shit about me since day one. Calling me a coward and shit like that.
You are a coward. That's why you turn violence to solve the problem. That's why you can't do what society asks of you. Why you walk around dressed like that.
The fuck you say? You don't know shit.
You hear me? You already lost yourself. But you're such a coward, you don't even realize it.
So what you're saying, you're not a coward? You think you're tougher than me?
I know I am.
Okay, then let's throw down. Prove you got what I don't got.
I accept your challenge.
Oh, no.
So that's what's happening, Makoto. You gotta be our witness.
You're gonna throw down? You're not gonna, like, start punching each other, are you?
There's a bathhouse on the first floor of the dorm, right? With a sauna inside?
I see. A simple endurance contest, isn't it? We're going to see if we stay in the sauna the longest, am I right?
Piece of shit. Goddamn straight!
Oh, come on.
Holy
right.
You know, this is a prime opportunity for murder.
Are you guys... Oh, sorry.
Are you guys really gonna go through with this?
Shit, yeah.
Done in a matter of minutes anyway. People like him are, without exception, all talk. You
want to throw down? Bring it on. Hell, let's make things interesting. Wouldn't want to win with a challenge, right?
Interesting?
You son of a bitch.
We're going to battle with all our clothes on.
That's idiotic. Suicidal. You
want to fight? What? You afraid?
Okay.
You're going to regret this. Stop
fucking around. Shut up and let's do this.
Uh-oh.
This is a prime opportunity for murder.
He's not...
Hey, Mondo!
He allowed him to take his off.
What, asshole?
You can take off your uniform, you know. Go ahead. I won't judge.
You can shut the fuck up and mind your own business.
No, that's you.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, but he's reading it.
Oh.
One of those goddamn hot spring monkeys.
What?
Monkeys
are boring on my face. You don't have to
He's got a towel hanging on his hair.
Yeah, I know.
Someone's gonna die. Someone's gonna die.
Are they okay?
No, this is a prime opportunity for murder.
A few minutes.
All Makoto has to do is lock the door and crank the sauna.
But then, if you go minutes, then an hour.
No one will know.
Don't just.
And think about it. Nobody would know. Sauna.
I'm just saying.
Thanks.
Hey, did you hear that? It's nighttime. How will we go all the time? Oh god, they're gonna die. They're gonna die.
Didn't they just punch each other out?
They're both gonna die. What the hell is wrong with his hair? How does he even do that?
I'm surprised it's holding its shape.
The gates of hell? That's not a good place to push someone. This isn't good, guys. Yeah, oh, it's you.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, you hear him? Better crawl on back to your room. I'll let you know how it went in the morning. Then you can start spreading my... my legend.
Someone's gonna die. Come tomorrow morning. You fall down in front of me, down on your knee. I'll show you where to do it.
Big talk from someone whose face is about to explode.
Makoto, why are you still here? Right back at you. Okay, well, good night, then. I'll leave you all to die. I really hope those two don't overdo it.
Yeah, they seem sensible.
But I'm sure to the death? No, surely they wouldn't go that far.
Yeah, of course not.
They're
both going to be dead in
the
morning.
The concern stayed with me as I slowly succumbed to sleep.
No way they survived that. Either Monokuma killed them, or the sauna killed them.
Monokuma doesn't kill anybody.
But they were out after...
Oh, did any of them fall asleep?
Yeah, you can be out of your dorm, but you cannot sleep anywhere but in your dorm.
They're dead.
And it didn't specifically state that the bathhouse and pool or anything like that. Morning, huh? Hope Mondo and Taka survived.
What's wrong? What happens in the dining hall?
Worried about the two of them. I hurried to the dining hall more quickly than usual when I entered.
What are you talking about, bro?
Oh! What are you talking about?
Oh, they're
best
gross.
Friends now? What the?
Hey, Makoto!
Thank you so much for acting as our witness here today. Huh? Are they...
what is happening?
It been like this all morning. They were all buddy-buddy as soon as they walked in. Feels gross.
Feels weird.
What? Feels gross? Hell no. Feels great, more like.
This almost feels like sexual harassment somehow.
Forget her, bro. A girl like her just doesn't get our manly bond. Friendship between men is stronger than blood. A woman should never understand.
Jesus.
What you just said? Bro, that was cool as shit. I should get a tattoo of it.
No, bro, you mustn't. Your body is a temple given to you by your loving parent. What is going on?
What is happening?
Who won the contest?
Who gives a shit?
Yeah, don't ask stupid questions. What matters is that we both took part in it together.
Something's not right.
No, it's very right.
Very simplistic. Nothing like what I'm used to with girls. Yeah, for real.
I'll throw breakfast that morning.
Friendship
the
between
world
men
was dominated
bro,
by Mondo and Taka's overpowering
brotherhood.
All in all, it was a pretty unfortunate experience.
Alright.
Okay, I think it's time to end the stream here.
Thank you so much for everyone who watched.
Okay, that's a good place. Yeah. Yes, thank you.
Very appreciative.
Look at that.
If you want to follow, please feel free.
What if you'd come to visit, I opened the door and someone forced their way in.
Well, she did already and I didn't notice.
Oh,
that's
I was
the case.
Say, I was thinking in my head, sorry. Yeah. Somebody really needs to make sure that Bafia and Topo are okay because we haven't seen them.
Why is she in my fucking room?
Because she knocked on the door.
Oh.
So if you knock first, you're allowed to go in.
No. We don't want to start anything new, so...
I think, we're going to end this.
Start
as painful as it is to stop right now, you've got to stop at some point.
Save?
It should save automatically, but...
Let's just be safe.
Save.
Top one.
Yeah. Anyway, as I was saying,
sorry.
Many thanks to anybody. If you did follow, I'm super appreciative. If I missed it, I'm sorry. I will send you a message. Please, check out MosaicOwl and Gamerbyrd23 when they stream. Also great. And this wraps up our.
What?
Did you have something to add? Huh. Any announcements? Anything you want to say?
No, not really.
Or? /MosaicOwl.
No.
Okay. So, this wraps up our fourth episode
of
Dangan Dangan Dabu Da Papa Do.
Let's pretend he said Danganronpa.
The thieving
trigger
finger.
Trigger happy habit.
That's what I said. Okay, so...
You're terrible at this.
We'll catch you next time.
Hopefully tomorrow.
Hopefully.
I've also got
a bully stream going that I do with Gamerbyrd here. And I've got Insomniac Star Wars.
Which you do by yourself, right?
Which I do by myself a little bit later. So...
Might do one later today?
Yeah. I'm unpredictable. I'm crazy. Anyway.
Taco Mondo.
Thanks, everybody.
And we will
appreciate the support. And have a good night.
See you later.
Say good night, everybody.
Bye.